Vigo can't be with us, but there's another happy ending. His speech can be with us. So his speech has come here, and the FAO has sent one of their most eminent, finest emissaries that they have to deliver it for you here today. So a heroine for stepping into the breach, and it's a great pleasure, therefore, to welcome on stage the words of Rodrigo, but delivered by the one and only Myrto Arvaniti. Myrto, come on up. And thank you. Manage.
Good afternoon. Let me apologize also on behalf of Rodrigo, who unfortunately didn't manage to be here with us today because of a family emergency. I will deliver the keynote speech. So, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, I'm honored to speak in front of you on behalf of the Food and Agriculture Organization. I wish to express my gratitude to the Barilla Center for Food and Nutrition for the kind invitation. I would like to congratulate them for the successful organization of their first International Forum of Food and Nutrition in Brussels. As you know, FAO is the UN specialized agency that leads with many other partners the international efforts to defeat hunger. And this year, we are also honored to be co-chairing the Global Migration Group together with the International Organization for Migration. We all know that 2018 is a critical year for the future of migration. This week, UN member states are engaged in the fifth round of negotiations towards the first global compact on migration, which would be adopted at a conference in Morocco in December 2018. As co-chair of the Global Migration Group, FAO is supporting the Global Compact negotiations, and it is bringing together its expertise, also the one of relevant technical expertise of 22 other UN entities. As a first input to the zero draft of the Global Compact, the UN Secretary General issued the report Making Migration Work for All. In this report, he reiterates once again how the Sustainable Development Goals can only be achieved if human mobility is taken into consideration. Indeed, facilitating safe, orderly, and regular migration is a specific target of SDG 10 to reduce inequality within and among countries. Ladies and gentlemen, agriculture and rural development matter today more than ever because for the first time in 10 years, hunger is on the rise. The number of chronically undernourished people is growing from 777 million to 815 million, reversing the positive hunger reduction trend of the last 10 years. We are putting at serious risk the Sustainable Development Goals, particularly SDG 2, Zero Hunger. And it is in rural areas where three quarters of the poor and hungry live. And a large share of migrants come from rural areas, as it is documented that around 40% of international remittances are sent back to these areas. Migration is largely shaped by structural and rural transformation processes, but migration flows themselves also affect rural areas in various ways. In many areas of origin, rural outmigration of youth can lead to the loss of the most vital and dynamic part of the workforce, with impacts on agricultural productivity and on the future of food systems. Where local jobs are lacking, investments in connective infrastructure specific to the food systems, warehousing, cold storage, and wholesale markets can generate employment in both agriculture and the non-farm economy, and thus participate in addressing the drivers of rural outmigration. We need to make the agriculture sector attractive, connecting it to marketing, processing, packaging, linking to their urban centers, enhancing agriculture along modern value chains. This is where FAO has a unique role to play in creating stronger and more resilient rural communities and expanding livelihood opportunities by strengthening rural-urban linkages. Strengthening agriculture value chains will create more employment and livelihood opportunities beyond primary agriculture. Non-farm activities associated with agricultural value chains need to be promoted and investments made in infrastructure linking effectively farmers and rural migrants to these value chains. Such effort, of course, must be combined with promotion of education and skills development aimed at enhancing employability in value chains and food systems beyond primary agriculture. In addition to the above, developing human capital is crucial for the development of rural areas themselves. This again calls for investments in education in rural areas and for further promoting the employability of rural youth through accessible training and skills development. It is also extremely important to remove any gender-related constraints that may prevent women from taking advantage of opportunities deriving from migration and increased mobility. Engaging key rural stakeholders, migrants, young people, in territorial development planning processes and foster their participation in an inclusive manner is of paramount importance. Such engagement is a prerequisite for developing sustainable and coherent policies and provide alternatives to rural population who see migration as the only way out of poverty and hunger. By creating sustainable employment opportunities in rural areas, rural people have the possibility to choose whether to migrate or to remain in their origin communities. And this is essential in order to make migration a choice and not a necessity. Supporting development of agricultural value chains that link rural areas to urban centers and thus contribute to the creation of rural on and off farm employment remains a priority for FAO. Ladies and gentlemen, FAO stands to further support the efficient and integrated agricultural value chains with much potential, responsive to the needs of rural communities and mitigating the risks of rural outmigration. We should all turn our sights to the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development and remind ourselves that this can be fulfilled only if agriculture and food systems become sustainable, so that food supplies are stable and all people have access to adequate nutrition and health. FAO is fully committed to work further with its partners to bringing the topic of agriculture, rural development and sustainable food systems in migration debates and interventions. And FAO stands ready to support member countries in translating global commitments in the 2030 Agenda as well as the coming Global Compact for Migration to concrete and sustainable actions in the ground. Thank you very much for your attention.